you. Welcome to my channel.
Jahaji Funday.
This is Gaurav Srivastav and this session is presented by me. So before this video I already made two videos on Banvas and GPS. LRIT, that is long range identification and tracking. So this video is on GPS. So I will be covering this video in parts because GPS have lot of topic to cover. And I don't think ये सारी topics एक ही video में आ पाएगी. So I made parts of this topic on GPS. But before that, just hold on for a second. Please like and subscribe my channel. And if you like this video, please put the like button on. And as I said earlier, that your comments are valuable to me. So please put the comments regarding changes, regarding any topic you want to include in my video, or regarding anything you can put in the comment box. But please subscribe my channel so that your support can grow me up and I can make more videos, more educational videos, exam centric videos for you. Thank you guys. Let's start today's topic, global positioning system. I will doing this topic in part because this topic have lot of things to cover. In this part, I will tell you about introduction and principle of GPS working. In the next part, I will be covering some important aspects of GPS, like segments of GPS, some important terminologies like CA code, P code. We will discuss these things in our next video. We have certain things also like GPS speed determination, errors, alarms, and differential GPS. So we will be covering these topics in the later video, but for now we are going to discuss about introduction and principle of GPS. Just like in the picture of the main display of GPS, it shows latitude and longitude of the user, as you can see in this picture. The latitude is 13 degree 04.953 minutes north, and the longitude is 048 degree 35.093 minutes east. So this is the position of the user obtained from the GPS. So this is the main display of the GPS. So here is some introduction to GPS. It is a satellite based system used to obtain the position of the user. As we are discussed earlier, GPS gives the position of the user. Second, principle used by GPS in obtaining position of the user by satellites as the references is trilateration. So trilateration is the name of the principle on which the GPS works. And the third one is, it is a satellite based system consists of 24 orbiting satellites in 6 different orbit. So the GPS can use any group of satellites among these 24 satellites to obtain fix of the user. The group of the satellite normally consists of 3 or more satellites for better accuracy of the position obtained from the GPS. So let us discuss trilateration in brief. We all know to locate, to obtain the position of the user, we use 3 methods. Either you have one bearing and one range, or you have 2 bearings, or you have 2 ranges. It means to obtain the fix, either it is there or it is there. So we are going to discuss the trilateration in brief by connecting with these things. We all know about a general formula: distance is equal to speed into time. We all heard about this formula, distance is equal to speed into time, which is a very basic formula. So in the GPS system, we all know the satellites gonna work. So satellite used to send signals in the form of radio waves, that is electromagnetic radiation, and it travels with the speed of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. This is the speed of light. So the radio wave travels with the speed of 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So from here we get the speed, and now the radio wave takes some time, the radio wave takes some time from this satellite to reach the user. The radio wave takes some time to reach from satellite to the user. Then we got the time from here also. So we get the speed and we get the time. We put in the formula and we get the distance. So from here we get distance. Now let us consider the distance obtained by putting the speed and time into the formula bx. This x is the distance obtained. So if you take the satellite and this is the user, so this distance is x. It can be in any direction because we have range, but we don't have the bearing. It can be here, it can be here, it can be here. So if you join all these coordinates together, you will get a circle. If you join all these coordinates together, because we only know the range, we don't have the bearing. We can be here, we can be here, we can be here, we can be here, we can be here. So we get the circle here. We all know that everybody moving in the three dimensional figure. So satellite is also there in the three dimension. So this circle is a two dimension. But if you're taking the satellite in the center, then this is not a circle. This is a sphere. So you can be anywhere on this sphere which is around this satellite. So now we get a sphere. Okay. So we can be anywhere on this sphere. Now we need another reference, another sphere or another satellite, we can say that, which is also a sphere. Now I am going to say it practically. If I take these two balls, which is the satellite 1 and satellite 2 sphere, and if I merge these two balls together, then you can see that there is a circle. There is a circle between, which is a common point, which is a common point between these two spheres, as you can see in the video, so that I can locate here. So this is the circle. This is the circle you obtain after combining these two spheres. So after combining these two spheres like this and like this, so it is like this. So this point or this plane is a circle. Previously we had seen that our position is somewhere on the sphere which is around that satellite, but now we are confirmed by combining these two spheres that our position is there on this two dimensional plane, on this circle. So we can be here, we can be here, we can be here, or we can be here, we can be here, we can be here, we can be here, we can be anywhere on this plane of circle. So to reduce the positioning of the user obtained by the satellite, we need obtained by the GPS, we need another reference which is also a satellite. Now we are using third satellite in our system. So consider this is a third satellite, and this is the circle we obtain after combining these two previously two spheres. So if I combine this circle and this sphere, which is a satellite, which is a satellite sphere, if I combine these two like this, then you can see. Then you can see I get two intersection points. One is here and second one is here. I show you like this. So if you combine these two, means one circle which you obtain after combining the two spheres earlier, and this is a third satellite we are using in our system. So after combining these two, you got two points, one here and second one is here. So It is confirmed after combining three satellites, after combining three satellites, that either we are locating here or here. So in the video we observed that we get two points after combining three satellite systems, three satellite pairs, or you can say that we get two points. Now the location of the user is either on point number one or point number two. So to confirm that, we need another pair, and that pair is the Earth itself. So the fourth pair is the Earth. So after combining these four pairs, we get the position fix of the user. So in this system, we used three satellites and one Earth. So total four pairs are used in the system, and this principle is called trial iteration. And this is the principle on which the GPS works.